lot of great potential. But healthcare isn't just for critics, it's all the people who do it always. Rather, something gets done. But we're not going to go do it. And it's a history. Lord, I've got to take some water that I want. people by the time of judgment. Set our place on the fire. We pray, dear Father, today, Lord, you have given us strength, Lord, to stand with you, Lord, that we care for you. God, I no crowd, no rain, and no wind. At least this word is saying no rain, and no wind. The first word is the word "this" will rain. This will rain. All of these words are synonyms. But God put it in my heart. You know what we ought to do? For the days that when we're out visiting, knock on that door. What a day you'll have. That is the victory. Here is the Son of God saying, the God for me. He that works in this way, God ever gave me. If we could get your lives, beloved, I think that would help us along with the second word. I don't think we always need to organize with God. I think that's very, very important. It's probably the most important thing. Have you brought a couple of things when we can organize with you? I had a man take the Bible for several times when I was in life. He was set up. I never could put the finger on it. I was young and started out at the ministry. But he would say it often. He would give the invitation. He would say, God's not a beggar. And I don't know why, but the scripture that he could never be described in the heart when he would say it. One day I was reading over there in the book of Corinthians. And the Apostle Paul said, with the sheep in Christ's name, be irreconciled unto God. You know what he was doing? He was telling us if Jesus was here, he'd beg you to get right with God. He's saying, I want to beseech you, I want to beg you to get right with God. I'm able to visualize the Lord and help us. I'm able to say, Pastor, please, Jesus, visualize. I do, don't tell me. You know what he sees? In front of him, a beautiful city. But Brother John, he sees judgment coming down the road. He sees the day when this thing's going to be unraveled, amen? Thank you for saying that. It's judgment in the future. 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 What do you think he was doing? He gives us a little bit of insight into Garden. See, I don't think that's the only time God, the Son, ever agonized with God the Father. I believe every time the Son of God bowed and prayed to the Father, he poured out his heart. I'm telling you, when he rose from the grave, he said, now, fellas, it ain't time to go yet. You're going to have to walk to Jerusalem. You're going to have to wait a while. And you're going to be endued with power from on high. It's said, then you will be witnesses of me in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost parts of the earth. I don't think you'll find a better visualizer than Jesus, a better agonizer than Jesus. I don't think you'll find a better organizer than Jesus.
Shut up! We're our Jesus, our son of David, our first children. shut up. So we didn't shut up. I can hear him tell the story of our God. We didn't shut up. We just showed up. Because we wouldn't shut up. I believe Jesus had him. What Jesus did to look at him. God done it thanks to you. When you see the amazing grace of the truth. Amen, Brother Jimmy. I once was blind, but now I see. Is that the truth? Jesus been through and walked that blind man and he did forgive him. And Father, this child is ready for the Lord. There's the gospel. I bet they didn't shut up. We saw Jesus just 2 days. He got that man 4 days. Now they go pray to him. He stood out in front of that man and said, Lazarus, come forth and here he comes. Everybody gets my picture. Everybody's ever been saved by a testimony. That testimony that he's to be saved. That testimony that he's not only going to be saved, but he's going to be saved. He's going to be saved. Conversation led me to quote, and everything of God worthy. If the grace on him is not contained up to the degree of God, it's condemned already. Because he has not believed in the name of your one God, the Son of God. He said, do you believe that makes you right? Yes, he said, that is the reason I've come. To those people down there in the camp, the church family, do they believe it? Would you explain to these men how it is that I've lived in this town 14 years? And nobody has ever asked me to be a Christian before. You're the first man ever to ask me that question. He said, Mr. Sunday, if I believe that scripture, I would get on my knees and ask you to pray for me. I said, that's what we need to do. You'd as well ask me to sleep for you. To drink water for you when you're thirsty. I said, you have to pray for yourself before God can save you. If God will save you, he will save you from our pain to you. He will do something to you. He did pray, and God saved you. Certainly, you had a right to save you. To those who make that. Every town has a few rings of hope, more or less. Every town has a few men that whatever they do, the town will do. If they go to hell, the town will do. The trouble with a good man is that the wrong thing is up there first to settle. So God will have to wait until they can get there, to their offspring out of the way, before it's a good thing. The town in Nebraska, the people kept telling me about one man. The Republic found that Nebraska was settled by the Federalists. From Fort Junction down to there, the wrong crowd got their money. Well, in this town in Nebraska, they said, there's one man here. If you can get him, he's good for 100 years of Christ. I said, who is he? They said, John. I said to Mr. Preston, have you been to prison? No. I asked another minister, he has been to fellow. No. I asked the United Presbyterian preacher, did I follow that thing? No. Well, I guess I'll go to him. I found the fellow seated in his stand. He was back against the wall and spoke. They put their finger through and call their own trouble. They don't want my wife to live with their wives. It's like the place. It's a joke. Their children won't play with our babies. They go by my house to go to school and play. They never ate stuff together. They pass the stuff. I never go to play. He said, I'm a Mason. I went to church 11 years ago when a member of the lodge came. But he Thank you.